Once you have a basic inventory of IT assets, the next steps are to add more details. Let's do it now. Hi, Matt Barron, Product Specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Insight, you can quickly gather asset information, whether through discovery or with an installed agent. If you haven't already done this, feel free to watch our video, 24 Hours to a Unified Inventory. And as always, you can get a free demo to follow along at try.invgate.com. Let's get started. If you've just run a discovery or added an agent to report the asset to a central inventory system like InvGate Insight, your next logical step would be to build a complete listing of all your assets. So, this might mean adding other segments from your network or running additional discoveries to collect more data. You might also be looking to integrate other sources. So for instance, you could add a Jamf Pro account or a Google Chrome management account to import devices from those, or even just installing the agent on additional devices. This will help build a more complete picture of your assets and their details. Next, each asset should have a status. Now, a majority of these, and what I've found, can just be set to active because I know that people are using them. But I know that I've got a few things that are either being repaired or in storage for when I need them. So I'm gonna set the status of these devices specific to their needs. This one, for instance, is in repair. If I go to my other assets here, like 106, I know that I've got that one in storage. So that one's ready to be commissioned to someone else. Once I know that there are active assets out there, it's super valuable to assign owners to each asset so I know who it belongs to. For example, computer 109, I can assign that out to Celeste. And if I've got other devices, I can assign those out as well. There are countless reasons to have this information populated, but one of the most useful and common uses is so that when they call, we can then see the devices that are assigned to the specific user and assign that asset to a specific ticket so we know that they've created an issue with that specific device. Asset management is all about tracking the asset as an investment. So it's natural then that the next things that we would want to provide would be the financial details and contract information associated with this asset. So I might go to the financials here or click edit to put them in. So here I've got the actual price of the machine, the invoice where we paid it, along with other details like what I'm going to track the depreciation rate as, and what the cost center is. What's nice about our system and the UI here is that if I don't have a cost center, I can actually just quickly create that cost center and get it assigned quickly. So you can see how we've designed this to be easy to enter data quickly. Having the original purchase price, depreciation, cost center, and warranty information makes it easier for us to decide how much equipment to purchase and balance our other decisions about support and warranty renewals. On the security and operations side of things, the next thing we would want to set up would be health rules and smart tags. These features make it very easy for us to see which assets need some care and support. And this also helps us segment our assets along the same lines. You might need to set up notifications and integrations for when specific actions are taken or thresholds have been breached as well. So using automations can make it easy to send emails or create tickets automatically. And finally, the power of visualizing how assets are related can be extremely useful for making changes and understanding the supply chain that the technology supports. Mapping and connecting them together into a CMDB can make last-minute decisions and change planning a breeze. So for instance, if I want to add CIs to a quick CMDB map, I can add in the specific assets that are being discovered, as well as any software, locations, people, or business applications that apply. So these assets all depend on provide a specific service. And these are just the beginning. I hope you see how InvGate Insight has been designed to make asset and configuration management a breeze. If you want to make your job easier, get a trial of InvGate Insight at try.invgate.com and give it a shot. For more on this topic, check us out on YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.